Now, as you know, we use left side very much for so many negativity. That is torturing us. But if there is no help, say from Mahavira, we cannot do it. We call the name of Mahavira, we could call him Saint Michael, we can call him by any name, but Mahavira because he was a human being. All this works out because of him, and he is such a great identity. He himself took a birth as a human being, difficult for saints to take birth as a human being. Moreover, you see the whole concept of hell and all that is described in any scripture is a fact, it exists. And if you try to go in there, you see, when I try to go there and to find out, I just go off to sleep sort of thing. In my sleep I find out all the things that are happening about person, how much he's got up, what he's done. It's not an easy thing to do with the conscious mind. You have to take to the subconscious and you have to go into sushupti in a deeper sleep to see what's happening in the left side. It's a very funny situation, I think. And for sahaja-yogis also to enter in it, I would not advise. But one should get rid of the problems of the left side with the help of Mahavira. When this chakra is caught up, what you find is a big lump of bone coming out on the right side. So you have to take the name of Mahavira just to remove that pressure from the left side. Now many people do not even know why they suffer. Why should they suffer when they have done nothing wrong? Because they are possessed. Now even the viruses and all these things like psychosomatic troubles like cancer, all I would say, the incurable diseases are there because we are triggered into the left side. That's why we are suffering from these diseases which are not curable. So we have to thank really very much Mahavira who has given us this power to remove our left-sided problems, who has given us this light in our hand, which he himself vibrates and he himself tries to throw some light on the obscure things about me also. Because of him only, we can get cured of so many physical and mental troubles. You know that the left side can be easily cured if you use 3 candle treatment. That shows Mahavira is only fond of light, he doesn't like darkness. And his idea is, I think that way, is to now fully go all the way to clear the left side as far as possible to help sahaja-yoga to be established in countries where I find still lot of this negativity is there, lot of it. So he is working it out everywhere. And the psychosomatic diseases and all these diseases also we can work it out with candle light and all that. With 3 candle we can do this trick. So we have to be very thankful to him that he has achieved this kind of entry into the left side and has found out for us what sort of problems exist on the left side. It's such a nice thing that we have got today the chance to celebrate his birthday here in a place which is really very much loved by him. Now you may say that Mahavira is sometimes seen as a person who is naked. So it happened that he had gone in a jungle to meditate and to find out about the left side. And when he got up, you see, he got caught up in one of the bushes. And he had to torn off half part of that. When that half part was torn off, then he came out of those bushes and he was all right. But at the same time, Shri Krishna appeared there on the scene as a little boy from a village. And he said that, "I am a poor man." This little boy said, "I am a poor person, I have nothing with me. You are a king, you can always get your clothes. Why don't you give me this half cloth that you have?" And they say so, that it was given to this boy, and who ran away. He was nobody else but Sri Vishnu. And this, you see, Vishnu took away that cloth, and hardly for about two seconds or 3 seconds, because he was a king, you see. And he hid himself with leaves and went to his palace and got dressed. But imagine the people, how negative they are. They just walk without clothes, Jainis. They have, you see, all kinds of taboos against all the worms, everything. It's said, these people have started, that if you do not respect these little animals, like you can say, even serpent, or any animal which is troublesome and bad, but is a human, is a living thing, so is to be preserved. Now these Jains are mad. I told you that they have gone to such a limit of vegetarianism that they try to save even the bugs.